Hey y'all, welcome to another episode of Tech Tuesday, brought to you by Victory Archery. My name's Nate Watts, I'm the QC manager for the company. So, it's that time of year. Hunting season's starting to wrap up, and target season's quickly upon us. So, today we wanted to talk about some of our large diameter target shafts. In the past, we had the NVX series, the VX series. Last year, we went through and redesigned our large diameter target shafts and really tightened up our tolerances and wanted to deliver a much higher end product, some lighter GPIs, better spine uniformity and consistency. It's just an improvement upon something that was already good, trying to make it better and better and better. It's always about building that better mousetrap for us here. So we're gonna be talking about our V-TAC series today. So you're gonna have three different arrows available in that series. You've got the V-TAC 23, 25, and 27. And those are gonna be your different IDs. So your 23, you're looking at a 0.314 inside diameter on that arrow shaft, and that's gonna be this arrow right here. So that's your 23 series. 25 series, you're looking at a 345 ID. 27 series, you're looking at 370 ID on that. So some cool things about this arrow. If you take a look at this, you're gonna see it's not just a standard modulus weave. We went and we put our 90 degree weave on the outside of this. And what that did is it allowed that arrow to have a lot tighter spine consistency. It's gonna recover faster on shot. It's just a lot more consistent of an arrow. So with these arrows, they're gonna come with a unibushing and the new AAE IP knock. So this is gonna be a knock that comes with your arrows. And you've got the different unibushings. So 27, 25, and 23. Now those are gonna be your standard products. So on these V-TAC arrows, with the three different series, you've got the 23, and that's gonna be available in three different spines. You've got the 270, 380, and 480. On the 270 spine, you're looking at approximately 7.2 average grains per inch, 380, 6.8, and 480 is gonna be 7.2 as well. 25 series, you're gonna be looking at a 300 spine, and that's gonna come in right at 7.2 grains per inch. 27, our largest diameter, our biggest fat shaft that we offer, you're looking at a 220 spine on that, and that's gonna come in right about 10.7 grains per inch on that. Cool thing, you're getting into a stronger arrow, but it's also lighter than the predecessors that we had, trying to give the best of both worlds there. As far as the points go, we went on ahead and redesigned the point profile of this. So that's gonna allow the arrow to penetrate the target better, but it's also gonna ease in the removal of the arrow from the target as well. These tips are also gonna be less prone to bending. You know, one of the things, when you go too sharp on a point, you get that sweeping bend after you hit something just barely wrong. These, you're not gonna get that. So these are gonna be available for the 23, 25, and 27. For the 23 and 25, you're looking at 80, 100, 120, and 150 grains. On the 27, you're looking at 150, 200, 250, and 300. So if those grain weights aren't quite what you're looking for, we do have some optional components available. So that's gonna be our back weight system. So these are gonna be available in 10, 20, and 50 grains. And if you wanted to change that point weight, all you gotta do is drop that weight in. Now I just went from a 100 grain point to 150 grain point right there. So these are gonna fit right inside the back of those points and allows you to really fine tune and dial in the arrow based on your shooting, how the arrow is coming out of your bow, and the spine of that arrow. As far as optional components go, we've also got pin bushings available for those of you guys that still want to run that pin bushing. But like I said, they're going to come standard with the unit bushing and AAEIP knocking a 166 OD. So that kind of breaks down the general stats of this arrow. But we kind of wanted to give you something more today. So I actually brought in our engineer, and he's going to be able to talk to you guys about some of the testing that was done, some of the reasoning behind why we went to this weave on the outside of this arrow and redesigned our entire target series. This is one of the guys that started it all, and he's always been an integral part of the team here. So I'd like to introduce you to Todd Barreto. Hey Todd, welcome to Tech Tuesday. Appreciate you coming out this morning for this.
That's right.
Today we're going over the V-TAC series arrows, and you played a huge role in this and how we ended up from this arrow to this arrow. So can you go on ahead and start, break it down for us? You know, where was your head at with how you designed this and where we were to where we are and what the benefits of that are?
Sure.
So here's some of the arrows you brought out for me this morning, so I'll let you go ahead and have those back.
Great, thanks. So first off, thanks for having me, Nate. It's a pleasure to be here. Apart from the new V-TAC series looking cool with this weave on the outside, the weave really provides three main benefits to this arrow series. The first off is, as most of you archers know, with an archer's paradox with a shaft, the first bending moment as you launch an arrow goes into a bending moment, and you have basically an oscillation of that arrow. So stabilizing that arrow quickly is of high, you know, importance to us, especially for a target archer. So what we found is by putting the weave on the outside and orienting the weave at a 0-90 degree orientation, is provides excellent hoop strength in this tube, in this arrow, so that when it does go into a bending moment, it doesn't want to ovalize as easy. And that's called the collapsing straw effect. And so what happens if you take a drinking straw and you just simply bend it, you'll see that it wants to collapse in its high compression area. And so minimizing that ovalization in the tube equates to the arrow recovering faster. So that's the first major benefit of the weave on the outside.
Well, you talk about the weave there. So this isn't the first time we've used a weave on an arrow shaft.
That's correct.
What made you go from our 45 degree weave, which we have available on our arrows, our TKO series, to the 0-90? What was...
Good question. So what Nate's referring to, you can see the orientation here. You can zoom in on this, the 0-90 degree orientation. So this orientation provides excellent hoop strength, as I was referring to in the ovalization. And if we orient this fiber and this weave at a 45 degree angle, that controls or reduces your torsional deflection in the shaft. In this case, because it's a target arrow and we're not that concerned with kinetic energy and losing energy in the torsional movement of the shaft, we're more concerned with accuracy and ovalization, because this is by far the thinnest wall tube that we make. It's down to the 18,000th wall thickness in some cases. So it's a very, very thin wall tube. So keeping that tube from basically collapsing or ovalizing is of high importance. That's why we orient the weave at a 0-90 versus a 45.
And that weave's what made it so much more durable than our standard modulus NVX series.
That's correct. Yeah, so if you go, this is the second major benefit of this weave on the outside. If you take, in this case, it's our standard prior model, our NVX model, and you can see it has no weave on the outside. And what we do at Victory here is we do a pretty severe impact durability test, where we take these arrows and we shoot them into a concrete wall at a short distance, so at maximum velocity, and we hit the wall with a field point. And basically what we've been achieving to do over years is have a uniform spalling, and you can see there the field point's been driven down into the shaft and it's spalling, it's basically failing, but it's failing in a uniform fashion, which means the arrow's been perpendicularly cut properly and that the shaft itself is taking all the compressive load evenly. What we found with the MVX, or with the V-TAC, excuse me, you can see that this same shaft has virtually no damage. It's still useless at this point, but you can see the spalling's been reduced from roughly 3 inches, 2.5 inches, down to about 1/4 of an inch. So that makes the shaft extremely durable. Again, for a target arrow, it's probably overkill, but there are a lot of cases where you get tail flap hitting shaft to shaft, you're shooting tight groups, or somebody else is shooting into your target, so you don't want to damage the shaft and not be able to see it. So this weave acts as a protective sheath.
Well, and just to emphasize something with this as well, both of these arrow shafts were shot out of the exact same bow, same distance, same poundage, into the same spot on the wall. So there's no variation between these shafts. And the other thing is, we took our own shaft. We didn't want to use a competitor's shaft, anything like that. We wanted to show you why we wanted to improve on our shaft. So there is no variation between the shot profiles on these arrow shafts, other than what you see here. I mean, the proof is in the pudding. This is leaps and bounds better than what you have here, so.
So the third major benefit of this weave on the outside of the V-TAC series is it is by far the most consistent arrow series we've ever made from a spine consistency standpoint. And the reason that is that the weave on the outside protects the unidirectional fibers underneath the weave, which is controlling your arrow stiffness, your spine. And so by not sanding or touching those fibers underneath this weave, it actually reduces the coefficient of variation significantly. So it is by far the most advanced, most consistent arrow line that we've ever made here at Victory, and we're really proud of it. And they look great and shoot great, and so go try them out.
All right, so Todd, thanks so much for coming out, breaking that stuff down for us. You know, I'm gonna try and have Todd come for some more episodes as well. He's really bringing a lot to the table as far as his knowledge and what he's shared with me and what he can eventually share with you guys. So yeah, that kind of breaks down our V-TAC series for you. If you have any questions, please let us know. Any comments, hit us up on Facebook, Instagram, check us out at www.victoryarchery.com. We'd love to hear from you. If you have any recommendations, questions for future episodes, please let us know. Kind of wraps it up for today, Todd. So
thanks
again for coming out.
Thank you.
This is Tech Tuesday. Have a great day.
Thank you.